microphone as if it were an ice cream cone. I like that image. My name is Linda Tarnay, and I'm thrilled to be here and grateful to all who made it possible. When I was about 8 years old, living in Florence, Alabama, the Jose Damon Company came to town and danced at the local high school. This was the company, the amazing first company of Jose, with himself, Lucas Hoving, Pauline Kohner, Ruth Currier, and Betty Jones. What a group, what a lineup. After the performance, I begged my father to take me backstage, which he did, and it turned out we were the only people to go backstage. And I was quite interested in the backstage view. I was interested in the fact that the men and the women were sharing the same dressing room, and that everybody smoked. So they came right off stage and started lighting up our two women there. At the restaurant, the dancers sat at one table, and my parents and I sat at another. And I inhaled everything I could inhale about them. I wanted to eat them, to absorb the essence of them, to be them, to run away to the circus with them. The girls all had tiny waists and long hair. The men were rather strange looking. Except for Jose, who was, of course, magisterial. I couldn't get enough of them. But when they had finished eating, they got up to leave, and Jose came over to my father and bowed with this elaborate courtesy that he always had, and thanked my father. And silently, the dancers filed out into the night, leaving my father with the bill for the five state dinners. Well, this was a calamity, actually, because we lived on a very tight budget, and it was the end of the month, and I felt sort of responsible for this. And I told my father I would wash dishes at the restaurant for the rest of my life to compensate for this. My father offered his wristwatch as collateral for the money owed. The guy let us off. His name was Ed, I remember. Years later, I went back to the American Dance Festival to study with Jose Limon. And as I was packing my bag to leave, my father said to me, "You tell that son of a bitch he owes me $25.